You really gotta give some respects to the physics team here. With the floating backpack and now the floating car, it's just true style, you know it's next gen. Next gen certified by yours truly. We got them next gen character models. We got that next gen sleeping quarters. God damn, look at this. I'd rather sleep on a fucking table, but hey, it's still enticing, right? Alright. God damn, they're throwing a whole horde at me right now. Didn't expect that. This motherfucking spitter boomer left for dead ass better fucking die quickly because I'm getting sick of this bastard. When people want to call something a bullet sponge in the game, those motherfuckers better think back to this sucker because goddamn, he's annoying. Alright, it's official. Absolute stunt god, move out of the way! Stunt god of 2015 Dead Island leaked build because you know what? Gotta be a stunt god for something in today's day and age. Don't get me wrong, but I'm pretty sure you're supposed to wear a backpack on your back. But I respect the developers for their extensive laws of physics. Ah, good example. Not sure why the car's looking like they came from the depths of hell, but that's okay, I respect their vision and ideas. You know when I said I hope we didn't have to kill any more of these slimy bastards? Well, now we have to kill 5 of them! And us being in a partly invisible store is making every single fucking zombie on the block come to this location. Like it wasn't hard already enough. Now I have to deal with every fucking thing coming at me at once. Like, great, great game, thanks. Oh shit, I'm about to die. It could be a lot worse though, cause I remember those fuckers from the first Dead Island, they'll sprint at you full speed like it's the fucking Demolisher. Like, hey, at least we don't see those yet. Oh, I actually killed one, finally. Fuck. So this game expects me to kill 4 more of these things, yet they spawn all of them fucking together. Come on, come on, come on. Almost got him. Gotta do a bit of a loop-de-loop because this fucking horde's in the way. Alright, alright, just let me on by. I'm no trouble. I'm just trying to kill your friend over here. What the fuck? Oh, I finally killed the booger. Hell yeah. Yes. Classic Dead Island physics. Gotta love them. Alright, alright, alright. I think it's time to see what these vehicles can do off the road. Still drive like shit, I guess. These driving physics are straight out of Cyberpunk 27 with how next-gen they feel. It really shows.
Highway to hell!
So I guess my ultimate mission is to steal a fucking tiara. That's cool. Very epic. Alrighty, let's get the fuck out of here. Oh shit. Oh yeah, I forgot they can break down doors. That shit's cool. Dying Light 2, learn from this. Oh shit, I can fit through the border here. I didn't even realize that. But you know, actually maybe develop some decent AI so they don't walk around like fucking stick figures just slapping their hands at you. And we're back to this. At least they can't kill me. Oh shit, we find sumo wrestlers now, huh? Oh shit, I can tell this dude's gonna take forever to kill. So this is a good opportunity to start experimenting with the weapons in this game, because honestly, this motherfucker ain't going down super easy, so I gotta see what does best. I do gotta say, I like the weapon variety, especially when you're looking at things like the pistols and stuff. There's a lot of different types of them. When you look at Dying Light, a lot of the cooler stuff got added in later as DLC, when there's only a few pistols to begin with. Here, I've picked up like 4, 5, 6 different types of pistols, and this is in a fucking broken build of the game too, so honestly, it's pretty cool if what they give you to use. I guess I upset this dude so much he's trying to break down the whole ass door looking for my ass. I see, I see. Here's another tip for you people trying to play the build of the game. If you're gonna pick any character, pick the blonde girl, because she gives you the best weapons and the most ammo to start out with. He's getting there, he's getting lower by the minute. It's not going as quick as I would like it to be. Alright, alright, this dude's actually giving me a little bit of a challenge now, huh? What an interesting little mini boss fight. That was kinda cool. Oh, okay. That's probably the most fun I've had playing this shell of a game so far, to be honest. I think the special zombies like this one are cool when they're put in specific situations where they can shine, you know, be their own type of zombie. When they're all crowding around all the other types of fucking runners and walkers, then it just doesn't make it as cool. Oh, he don't got pants! Oh, no, he do got pants. Okay, alright. Just gotta make sure. God damn, this man double-cheeked up on a Thursday afternoon.
Double-cheeked up on a Thursday afternoon?
Stopped by the shop over here for a bit of an upgrade, and now we got a big old sledgehammer to smash some heads in with. Holy shit, I found the best weapon in the game. Here we go. This reminds me of the dropkick event they would have in Dying Light, where you'd fucking kick the zombies across the goddamn map. That's what's going on here, it's crazy. I love it. And to sky high they go. Tips to those that decide to play this piece of shit. Get the sledgehammer, it's literally the greatest weapon and you're invincible. Fucking swing zombies into the air like you're some type of fucking Hercules player or something, I don't know. Oh, nice, we found like a safe zone. Damn, Mr. Van Man over here is looking rough. But you're the only one who can help the survivors. Ah, yes. I forgot about bootleg Jack Black.
If you untie me, I will literally suck your dick right now.
I told you, for the last time, I love the pussy.
I'll cradle the balls, stroke the shaft, work the pipe, swallow the gravy. Get it over here, buddy. Let's do this.
As you can tell, Jack Black is amazing. So if I were to come to a general consensus of what I think about this game, I think it's okay. I think it's worth downloading and playing for a few hours, but that's kind of it. There's really not much here, and it's pretty frickin' weak compared to a lot of other things that you could be playing right now, so... I mean, yeah, check something else out and not waste your time with this, just to be as simple, straightforward as possible. It's cool. It has its good things, it has its bad things, but honestly, it doesn't even really feel like Dead Island very much. Feels like Dead Island, Sunset Overdrive, and Dead Rising all had a baby, and that's okay. I like their vision, I respect what they tried to go for, but as a Dead Island game, it's really disappointing. So I hope their next rendition of the game is a lot better, and we'll see it. Maybe we won't. I don't know. Time will tell. Anyways, thanks for watching. I'll see you all in the next one. Peace.